Hello friends and welcome. So today we will see the experiment on series resonance. Okay, so in this experiment we will see how your series resonance circuit works. Okay, we will find out the various parameters for this circuit. Okay, and then I will show you the live simulation of this series resonance circuit by using online simulator Multisim Live. Okay, so friends, before starting the simulation, let us understand how this circuit works. So series resonance circuit basically consists of all three elements R, L and C. So when we apply some AC voltage, what happens? Current starts to flow through this circuit and three voltages will develop across three individual elements. So friends, when we want to convert any RLC circuit in resonance circuit, we have to achieve this condition. This condition is known as condition for resonance, means your inductive reactance should be equal to capacitive reactance. So friends, this is your formula for XL and this is formula for XC. From this formula, what you can identify? If you increase the frequency, your inductive reactance will go on increasing. And simultaneously your capacitive reactance will go on decreasing. So friends, we know what is the equation for resonant frequency, 1 upon 2 pi under root LC. So we are having the values of L and C. If we put these values here, we will get the value of resonant frequency. So friends, the values of R, L and C we are using here are respectively 1 kilo ohm, 1 millihenry and 1 microfarad. So if you put these values over here, you will get the value of resonant frequency as 5.032 kilohertz, which is nearly 5 kilohertz. Okay. So friends, our aim is to now plot the current graph for this series resonance circuit. So you have already studied the theory part. I have already prepared one video on series resonance circuit. The links are available in description. So now with the help of online simulation tool, we will try to plot this graph for this circuit. So in Multisim Live, we will design this circuit. When we run this circuit, we will try to match our theoretical result with experimental result. So if you look at this graph, what you will find out? Initially, your current is less. As your frequency goes on increasing, what happens? Current will go on increasing. Your current will reach peak point at some frequency. That frequency we are calling as resonant frequency, which is in our case, it is around 5 kilohertz. And if you increase the frequency beyond 5 kilohertz, again, your current will go on decreasing and finally current becomes zero. So you are getting the graph like this for current in series resonant circuit. Okay. And what you have to do, friends, you have to convert this current value into decibel value. Okay. And when you subtract 3 dB from the highest value, you will get minus 3 dB value. Okay, suppose I am having 100 dB value over here, so I will subtract 3 dB. So what I will get? 97 dB. So I will check 97 dB on this graph, and from these points I will take vertical projections and I will get two different frequencies. These are called as lower cutoff frequency and higher cutoff frequency. It means always you have to operate the circuit in between these two frequencies, lower and higher cutoff frequency. So our aim is to calculate this lower and higher cutoff frequency for the series resonant circuit. And the difference between higher and lower cutoff frequency is called as bandwidth of this circuit. Okay. So friends, let us start the simulation. So friends, just go to this website Multisim Live. I have provided a link in the description and I have also prepared one video how to use this Multisim Live simulator. Okay. The link is available in the description. So just you have to click on login. If you are not created account on this, first time you have to sign up. Okay, so I will click on login. So this window will appear. Enter your email and password and just click on sign in. So friends, after login, this window will appear. This is your dashboard. Here your name and other details are written. Here number of circuit designed by you are indicated. Okay, and on the bottom side, the recently created circuits are available. Okay, so if you want to create new circuit, on the right top corner, you have to click on create circuit. I have already prepared this series resonance circuit. So I will click on the bottom. So here you can see I have already created series resonance circuit. Okay. So I will click on this circuit. So friends, this window will open. Now I will click on this open circuit. So now you can see our circuit is initializing. So friends, now you can see I have already designed this circuit by using the values stated in our problem. So what values we are using? 1 kilo ohm, 1 millihenry and 1 microfarad respectively. How to use this component? Just go to the left side. So here various options are available. Here you can see resistor, capacitor, inductors are available. So I have selected the values. Okay. If you want to change the value, just double click on the value of any component and using this slider, you can change the value. Okay. If you want to put any random value, you can also type by using keyboard. Friends, here you can see I have connected an AC supply. Okay, which is of by default 1 volt and 1 kilohertz. Now I want to change this. So what I will do, just I will double click on the value of voltage. Okay, suppose I want to connect some 30 volt over here. Okay, so I will type the value 30 volt. Okay, so you can see now 30 volt AC supply is connected with this circuit. I have taken a ground node over here. Okay, and in order to measure the current flowing through this RLC circuit, because we have to plot the graph of what? current. Okay, current versus frequency graph we have to plot. So what we will do, I will use a current probe. From where you are taking the current probe? From the first option on the left hand side. So you are having this current probe which is acting as an ammeter. So I will take a current probe and I will place it over here. Okay, if you want to change the name, just click on the name of this probe. So what I will do, I will give some name of my choice and I will press enter. So you can see now this ammeter is showing the series current flowing through this circuit. Okay, I will click on the run simulation button. So friend, what happens when I click on run simulation button? Timer starts running and your circuit now starts simulating. If there is some error in this, the error window will open on the left hand side. Now here you can see the current is changing very drastically. Why? Because our frequency is very high. Okay, so current is changing very rapidly. So what you can do, friends, just click on the ammeter and instead of instantaneous value, you can select periodic value. So what you will get, peak to peak value, then RMS value of current, average value, and what is the frequency you are getting. Okay, so these things you are getting. Okay, so now this is the circuit. Now I want to check the waveform of this circuit. I want to check the current waveform. So what I will do, friends, I will click on this grapher button. Okay, so now you can see this is your current waveform. Okay, so if you want to see the circuit as well as waveform simultaneously, click on this split button. So now you can see your circuit as well as your waveform, both are visible simultaneously. So friends, now we will focus on this waveform. Okay, so if you want to change, this is like a CRO waveform. If you want to change the property, just on the right hand side you are having this gear button, so which will open the configuration setting. Okay, just go on the downside. So if you want to change the time per division, you can change from this left and right arrow. Okay, so you can change the dimension of your waveform. Again, if you want to change the maximum value and minimum value, so if you look at this, what is your maximum value? 40 milliampere and minus 40 milliampere. Okay, so if you want to change, suppose I want to change this to minus 50 milliampere, so it is minus 0.05 ampere and 50 milliampere. So now you can see, friends, on the y-axis you are having plus 50 and minus 50 as maximum and minimum range. Okay, so you can change the values as per your need. Okay, if suppose your waveform is going out of this display, so what you can do, just click on the axis, and if I click on the current, what happens, friends? Your multisim live will automatically adjust the waveform so that you will get the complete waveform in your window. Okay, so use this option when your waveform is larger than your display. So suppose if it is going out of this display, suppose if this peak is going above this, if it is not visible, then click on this axis and click here. So what happens, automatically complete waveform will get adjusted as per your screen. Okay, so friends, now you can see your waveform is stable, but many times on CRO you will find out that your waveform is changing. So how that is possible? So here on the trigger option you are having normal. If you select none, so what happens, you will get this real time waveform. But since our waveform is changing very fast, so if you want to stabilize the waveform, just click on the normal button. So what happens, your waveform will stop. Okay, now here you are getting positive cycle first. If you want negative cycle first, then you have to click on this edge detection. So now what happens, your negative cycle is starting from zero. Okay, and if you want both cycles, then it will be like this. So best way, use rising edge detection. So what happens, your positive waveform will come first and then negative waveform. Okay, so friends, this is the graph between current versus time. Okay, but as per our need, what we want the graph between current and frequency. Y-axis what you are having current, and on x-axis you are having time per division, means time parameter you are having. Now I want to change this time parameter to frequency component. So here you can see we are having this interactive graph. Just go to the drop down menu and select AC sweep. Okay, and again click on the run button. So now what happens, your graph will get converted into logarithmic scale. Okay, so friends, here you can see our frequency, minimum frequency is 1 hertz, and here you can see your x-axis parameter is now changed to frequency in hertz. Okay, maximum frequency is 10 gigahertz. Okay, and we are getting two graphs. So one graph is for magnitude and another graph is for phase. So here in the right hand side on the options, you are having phase and magnitude. We do not need phase, we are focusing only on the magnitude of current, how current is increasing and decreasing. Okay, so here friends, if you go on this graph, if you move this cursor, so what you will find out, first parameter is frequency at 3.16 kilohertz. What is the current you are getting? 999.54 microampere. This is the current you are getting. Okay, so friends, here your y axis as well as x axis is in logarithmic scale. So better way, what we should do, frequency we will keep in logarithmic scale because range of frequency is very large, but range of current is very small. So instead of using logarithmic scale, we can change the magnitude to linear scale. How this is possible? So on the right hand side, go downwards. Okay, and here you can see vertical scale. So instead of logarithmic, now what I will select? I will select linear scale. So friends, now you can see your current 1 milliampere, 2 milliampere, 3 milliampere means you are getting linear scale. So friends, now what I will do? I will adjust the Y parameter. So what is your minimum current? 10 nanoampere. And instead of 10 milliampere, now what I will do? I will select 2 milliampere and press enter. So now you are getting the proper graph. Okay. So friends, if you compare this graph with our theoretical graph, so same type of graph you are getting. So what is happening, friends? Initially your frequency is 0. So since we are taking logarithmic scale, instead of 0, now our frequency will start from 1 hertz. If you go on increasing the frequency, what happens? Current goes on increasing, then current reaches to maximum, and after that again current goes on decreasing. So same thing you are getting in this simulation. Initially current is very less. If you go on increasing the frequency, now you can see, friends, your current is increasing, okay, and your current is maximum. So if you want to note at what frequency current is maximum, so here you can see, friends, what is your frequency? 5.0119 kilohertz, and at that time current is 1.000 milliampere, means 1 milliampere. Okay, so friends, this is nothing but your resonant frequency. What you can observe here, your current goes on increasing, it reaches to maximum value. So this point here, your current is maximum, which is 1 milliampere. Okay, and after this point, what happens, friend? Your current goes on decreasing like this. Okay, so this frequency is called as resonant frequency. Okay, now our aim is to measure this frequency when our current is 1 milliampere. Okay, so what is the frequency you are getting here? At around 5.011 kilohertz, you are getting maximum current, which is nothing but 1 milliampere. So if you move further, you can see current is decreasing 996, 993, 998. And if you decrease below this 5.011 kilohertz, again you can see your current goes on decreasing. Okay, so this 5.011 kilohertz, it is nothing but our resonant frequency. Okay, so practically what frequency we are getting? 5.011 kilohertz. So friends, here you can see what was our theoretical value, 5.03 kilohertz, and here practically what we are getting? 5.011 kilohertz, means almost same frequency we are getting. So our theoretical and practical results are matching. Okay, so friends, now we have to calculate FL and FH. So what I have told you, there are two ways. Either you can convert this current value from milliampere to decibel and subtract 3 decibel, or what you can do, you can multiply this maximum value of current by a factor of 0.707. So if your maximum current is multiplied by 0.707, again you will get the values for FL and FH. So I will show you how to do this. So friends, now here you are having maximum value of current. So multiply this maximum value 1 milliampere by 0.707, okay, and check the corresponding frequencies. Okay, so if I multiply this current with 0.707 multiplied by 1 milliampere, so what you are getting? 705 microampere. Okay, what is the corresponding frequency? 158 hertz approximately. So note down this. So friends, here you can see what was our maximum current, peak current, 1 milliampere, and what is our 0.707 multiplied by peak current? 0.707 milliampere. So what was the corresponding lower cutoff frequency? Nearly 158 hertz. Now we will check for higher cutoff frequency. So friends, here you can see what is your current? 0.707 milliampere, means nearly 708 microampere. So what is the corresponding frequency? 158 kilohertz approximately. Okay, so we will note down this value. So friends, 0.707 milliampere is nothing but around 707 microampere. So we have checked what is the higher cutoff frequency at this current, and that frequency was around 158 kilohertz. Okay, so we have got the FL and FH. Now we can take their subtraction and we will get the value of bandwidth as 157.84 kilohertz. So this is your frequency. So friends, we have calculated this frequency from the linear scale. So suppose what I have done, I have multiplied the maximum current by this factor 0.707. If you don't want to do this, what is the other way you can do? Just convert this current into decibel. So how that is possible? So friends, if you want to convert this current into decibel, what you have to do? Go to the vertical scale. Here instead of linear option, select the decibel option. So friends, here you can see at resonant frequency, which is nothing but 5.011 kilohertz, what we are getting? -60 decibel. So now your current is converted into decibel. We will note down this value like this. So friends, here you can see what is your maximum current, minus 60 decibel. Okay, now I want to calculate FL and FH. Okay, so when I was having current in linear value, I have multiplied with 0.707. But when your current is in decibel value, you have to subtract 3 decibel from this maximum value. So minus 60 minus 3. So what you are getting? Minus 63 decibel. Okay, so check for the 63 decibel points on this graph, both below FR and above FR. So you will get lower cutoff frequency and higher cutoff frequency like this. So friend, this is your 60 decibel point. Now I will go to the minus 63 decibel. So friends, you can see this is nearly minus 63 decibel. What is the frequency you are getting? Again 158 hertz. And if you take the higher cutoff frequency, again minus 63 decibel you have to take. So minus 62.98 means around minus 63 decibel we are getting. So what is the higher cutoff frequency we are getting? 158.49 kilohertz. So note down these values. So friends, we have written the values of lower and higher cutoff frequency. If you compare these values with the previous value, 158, here again 158 kilohertz, again 158.49 means almost same value we are getting. Okay, and if we subtract higher minus lower, so what you are getting? 157.84 kilohertz, which is same as our previous value. Okay, so friends, you can calculate the bandwidth by using linear scale as well as decibel scale. Okay, so in this way you can find out the bandwidth for any series resonant circuit. Okay, so again one factor you can calculate, that is called as quality factor. So friends, this is the formula for quality factor of series resonant circuit. It is ratio of resonant frequency and bandwidth. So we are having both these values. Put these values, you will get the value of quality factor as 0.03. okay, so this is the value of quality factor for this series resonant circuit. Okay, and higher the value of quality factor, better will be your circuit. Okay, so friends, in this way you can perform the experiment on series resonant circuit by using Multisim Live. Okay, so even though you are not having any experimental setup, by using this online simulator you can get all the results for this series resonant circuit. So I hope you have understood this video. Okay, so if you like this video, please press the like button, do share this video with your friends, and if you really like my video, please subscribe this channel. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.